Now I'm taking Ink Pink by Maybelline and I'm putting that on my lid up to my crease. I'm taking this Satin Shadow Bruised Sky from a palette from MAC Interior Life. With a 239 brush from MAC, I'm placing that shadow on my lid. With the same brush, I'm taking African Violet from the Laura Mercier Pro Palette and I'm putting that over the shadow on my lid. Next, with an angled brush from Crown, I'm taking Cafe Au Lait and I'm going to work that in my crease. Chocolate from the Laura Mercier Pro Palette. Concentrating on the outer corner of my eye, I'm going to place that chocolate shadow at the outer corner and sweep it up into my crease. To create some depth, I'm taking a Sigma Performance brush and I'm really going to blend that chocolate shadow into my crease and outer corner. Taking a 219 from MAC and the Shadow Rich Coffee, I'm going to begin at the outer corner of my eye and start placing that shadow in the outer V area. Outer V area, so I'm taking a Sigma crease brush and I'm really going to blend that rich coffee shade into my outer crease and also give the illusion of a higher crease by dragging the shadow with the brush following my natural eye shape. Taking a crown angled brush and a shadow close to my skin tone and I use Vanilla Nut from the Pro Palette and also I want to brush away any harsh lines left from using the tape and any fallout which may have occurred. Mini shader brush from Sigma and Beauty Mark by MAC and I'm just going to emphasize my lashes by placing the shadow in the lash line area and in the outer V area. Trooper from the KatVonD liner collection, I'm going to begin lining my eyes, lining the shape of my eye close to my lash line, and also this will be a guide for where I want to place the false lashes. For more tips and tricks for applying winged eyeliner, there will be a link in the description bar that will take you to a full eyeliner tutorial. Are Demi Whispies by Ardell. The tool that I'm using to help my lashes adhere to my lash line is from Crown. I applied my foundation and concealer. If you want more foundation tips, again, there will be a link in the description bar. To define my brows, I'm using a Rae Morris liner brush. Brow gel from Makeup Forever. A good tip is to shape your brows with the wax first so that the brow powder has something to adhere to. A good tip is to use the lighter shade to fill in the brows and the darker shade to line the brows. Lighter and darker shade, they offset one another, giving for a more natural look. With a light hand, I'm using the sides of the eyeliner from Rimmel and lightly going over the hairs of my brow. Look. This will also serve as a highlight for my inner tear duct as well. Taking a white pigment from E.L.F. and a Real Technique precision brush, and I'm going to put that in my inner tear duct and my brow bone for a highlight. Contour brush from Rae Morris, Radiance, number 27, and a bronzer from MAC. I'm going to place the MAC bronzer in the hollows of my cheeks. Violet shade, I'm going to smoke out the lower lash line. shade brown and lining the lower lash line. For a light smoldering effect, I'm taking coffee and a 239 and placing that shadow on the outer corner and just blending it inwards. I'm using MAC Volume Mascara to ensure that my natural lashes blend in with the Ardell Dempsey's. So I'm placing that on the upper lashes and on the lower lashes as well. So here is the final look. And thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. As always,